Possibly tune in to at this moment in time in your life.
Please give it up for
King. I am sitting here with the wonderful Chrisette Michele and Mr. Justin. Hi, Justin. Hi, Chrisette. How are you? Yes. If you're here in St. Louis, is this your first? No, this is your first time here. You were here a while back.
How many times have
you been? Oh, my God. But you know
what? Even in the last year, yeah. You guys are so full of love and you always sell out the show. So
yeah. Thank you. That's because we love good music. And when you produce good music, then of course you're going to get great fans, right? Yeah. So tell me about some projects that you're working on now.
Me and Justin are working on something called The Lyricist Opus. We just released the first single for free at the website, redshipster.biz, but everybody picked it up and put it all over their blog sites. It's called Super Chris. So okay. If you listen to it, you'll hear Justin on the guitar, and then he produced and arranged all the other instruments along with Scott and Gil, who did the orchestra, which was the biggest, coolest thing.
So how awesome is that for you to be working? Well, you guys work together all the time, but
first time
in this
on
capacity.
This level, yeah. First time on this level, but it's great, and I'm learning a lot from her, you know? I'm learning a lot from her, and we're learning a lot together, you know?
Okay.
So just taking it go.
Well, let me ask you this, because I think sometimes when people are friends, they forget to learn from each other. Because when you're doing something like this and you're working in a collaboration, you have to grow together in a sense. So how do you tell people, how can they achieve?
Will she preach on tonight?
I'll just say, how do you get other people to see the same concept, the same vision?
You know what? It's like a ridiculously insane, out of control amount of communication.
Okay.
Like, it's out of control. I mean, we talk about the most ridiculous things, from the sound of the cymbal to how, you know, a marimba should be mixed to, you know, if we should use two violins or, you know, four violins. I mean, it's like ridiculous. And every single thing, we are both so particular, so we both have an hour-long conversation about each detail. So we spend a lot of time talking.
Yeah.
We don't agree all the time.
Of course.
But the good thing about being great friends and being professional in what we do, we know when to let back and let the other one shine, you know?
Yeah.
So it's a lot of that goes on, a lot.
So how would you define the tone of the album that you're working on?
It's super honest. This time I decided to just like talk about what I'm actually experiencing.
Okay.
A lot of times in R&B or soul music, you feel obligated to talk about love or a relationship. We do have one relationship song on there called Together. But, you know, Super Chris is about some of my insecurities. You know, I don't think I'm the only person who checks their Instagram and say, ooh, ouch.
I did it earlier.
You know, ow, that wasn't nice.
I did.
You know, so, I mean, I talk about my self-esteem. Yeah. You know, I talk about my insecurities. And then what's so exciting about it is that I got to sit with Justin like while I was coming up with the lyrics, or a lot of times I would dream the lyrics and then say, Justin, I just dreamt this or whatever. And he would play it to me on the guitar. And so it was this really interesting marriage of, you know, two different gifts working together. It's kind of cool.
Oh. Well, that's amazing in and of itself. And I'm so excited to listen to you tonight.
Thank you.
Honestly, it's my first time, and I watched you grow and move within the industry, and I love everything that you did. And then earlier today, for those of you who did not tune in, you were speaking truth to the table of young folks, and we need that more often, especially everybody knows what's going on around here. You know, things have gotten well out of hand.
Yeah, I got to meet with the mayor today.
Oh, wonderful.
Of St. Louis, and just shake hands. I mean, a lot of times, you know, actions speak louder than words, and you may not always know exactly what to say, but just showing up at the mayor's office
is huge.
just to be brown skin and walk into this office and stand in front of the American flag and take a picture and put it on Instagram says so many things.
It screams
volumes. It says paying attention and not watching what you're doing. So you know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
And now young people are watching because my audience on Instagram is going to either like or not like this photograph.
Mm.
So, you know.
A few more of you may want to take the concept. I'm not throwing shade though. But anyway, all it's all love. It's all love. But I could not have said that better myself. And that's an amazing thing. And we've had people coming through left and right. But what we haven't had is that. You know, if you're coming through, stop at the place where we need to stop at. You know, and
it's only
by the
grace of God we even got to go there.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, God always says you are where you're supposed to set up. I ain't know ultimately.
Yeah,
but I knew what to do when we got there.
Hey, now.
Brown. He's brown.
Yes, Weez is. Well, thank you for talking to me today. I can't wait to see you perform and
it's gonna be a fun
and
show.
Have a good time.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, thanks. Black DVD, we'll holler back.
We're Chipster.
Can you?
G-Slay.
And all that.
Super Chris.
Peace. That's a peace sign. Just in case anybody else is going through this, growing up as a kid, I was dyslexic and I had ADD. And so school was a big fat joke for me because I felt like I wasn't smart enough. I felt like I couldn't get ahead. And so I had to learn how to really apply myself like in another kind of way. A lot of kids around me dropped out of high school, but my parents really pushed me to stay. And so, you know, coming up with ADD and not having great comprehension when I read is what led me to get my first job at a library, because I wanted to be, if I was gonna have dyslexia, I was gonna be able to outread anybody, outcomprehend anybody, be more articulate than anybody, because it was my challenge. So then I ended up going to a really small college so that I could have more attention. So it's called Five Towns College. It's a private college for music in Long Island, New York.
Wow.
Long story, short answer, I know. My biggest fear in the music industry is singing songs about myself. Most of the songs that you guys hear are songs about what someone else is going through or somebody I met, you know, at a forum like this where they told me their story and I said, oh my God, I gotta write you a song. I've always tried to write soundtracks to other people's lives. But Super Chris and the lyricist Opus is really the soundtrack to my life. It's not too many love songs on it because love is the easy part. You know, the hard part is self-acceptance, self-actualization. So, yeah. So songs about myself are the scariest.
The young people in a transition living program. If you had something inspirational that you wanted to say something, what would that be?
You know, my mom had a home for young people in transitional living, and that was how I was raised. So all I saw my whole life were people in transition. And when you're in transition, I think besides all the things that you go through on the inside, it's the relationships that you go through on the outside. Meeting people and leaving people was the hardest thing for us. Meeting people in transitional living circumstances. But I think living with the attitude of gratitude and being thankful for the moments that you get to experience with each person and then taking it with you wherever life takes you. Just because somebody's in your life just for only a season doesn't mean that they're not a real valuable part of your life. It doesn't make them any less your family. I have 100 sisters. Some of them I speak to now. Some of them I've lost their phone number, but they're still my sisters. We've still experienced together, and there's still valuable relationships that I can call ones that I've had. So if you're in that type of a situation, be encouraged. You do have family, and they do love you.
Yes, sir. Young man down there.
What's the best part about working in the music industry?
Best part of working in the music industry is meeting people. I mean, hearing people's stories is amazing, and hearing them from all over the world. On my website, richhipster.biz, there's a story I wrote called No at First Sight, where I sat down with this Italian man. He just sat down at my table, I was eating pizza, and he told me what he thought about love in America. And I fell in love with somebody, you know, in Rome. We kissed on the first day. Just all these different ideas of how people think from all over the place, and getting to meet so many different ideas and people. It's such a personal thing.
girl who I call my sister, she had to overcome so many personal challenges, forgiving so many people that she felt did her in a way that she didn't appreciate. And that was the first step to her coming into her own, was walking away from what she felt like she didn't deserve, even though she wanted those people's validation, and forgiving them for not validating her, and then becoming her own validation to be strong enough to go into what was next. Do you know what I mean? Once you can validate yourself, then you'll give yourself what you deserve, and it'll come little by little. Follow your heart and keep God first, and all things will be added to you.
Yeah. I've been a fan of yours ever since you dropped with Nas back in the day.
Thank you.
And I've always gotten Sarah Vaughan in your music when you sing. Is she like one of your biggest inspirations?
You know what? It's Sarah Vaughan, Billie Holiday, Ella Fitzgerald, Art Blakey, Biggs Beiderbecke, Art, you know, just all the real jazz heads. I went to school for vocal jazz performance. So those are the people who I really like studied and fell in love with the first as a kid. Yeah. That and hip hop.